Today, I would like to explain AC to AC converters in the power electronics. In AC to AC converters, we have two types, that is single phase AC voltage regulators and three phase AC voltage regulators. In this video, I would like to explain single phase AC voltage regulator. Introduction. So first we will see what is the definition of AC to AC converters. By connecting a reverse parallel pair of thyristors or triac between AC supply and load, the voltage applied to the load can be controlled. The main object of this topic is to maintain or to control the output voltage of AC. So this is a AC to AC converter which is connected or between the supply to the load. And here we will take in this block, we will take anti-parallel pair of or reverse parallel pair of thyristors or a switch advanced which we will take, that is triac. So purpose of AC to AC converters. AC voltage regulators convert fixed main voltage directly to variable alternating voltage without change in the frequency. So the main purpose of this voltage controller is to convert or to change fixed to variable here. Here it is fixed, here it is fixed, and here it is variable. Variable AC voltage without changing in the frequency. AC to AC voltage converters operate on the AC mains essentially to regulate the output voltage. Applications where we use such type of converters means, so here we have to consider what is the output value. Here by AC to AC conversion we will get variable AC voltage at the output. So based on that one, we will give the applications. See here. So speed control of polyphase induction motor, which is the AC motor and which is having the variable speed. Domestic and industrial heating, second application. And third application is light control. And fourth application is on-load transformer tap changing. And fifth, this is very important in the power system, that is static reactive power compensation. So such type of converters generally we use in the FACTS devices. Single phase half control AC voltage controller. So according to the definition of AC voltage controller, a reverse parallel switch is connected across the source to load. Here it is only half control. In place of thyristor, reverse thyristor, here we will consider a diode. So here the supply is AC voltage. AC voltage we will give the as an input. So here, the current is passing through like this in the for positive half cycle. So here when we give the alpha, that is delay angle to this thyristor, so the conduction starts for thyristor is this one. So here this one for a positive half cycle, this is the output voltage. But in reverse we are connected diode which is unidirectional. There is no control in the negative half cycle, so you will get full voltage here. So here if you observe, this only half cycle we are controlling. Whatever amount of supply is given to the negative supply, that we are getting. This is uncontrolled and this part is controlled. That's why it is only, it is called half control value. So here control of AC voltage controller is two kinds. So here first type of controller is with anti-parallel connection of ACR or reverse parallel connection of ACR. So here this both switches can be replaced by like this with single switch called triac. So here triac is the advanced switch where we use direct conversion of AC to AC with fixed voltage AC voltage to variable voltage. So here single phase AC voltage control with resistive load. So very simple anti-parallel connection of thyristors. This thyristor will act for positive half cycle and this for negative half cycle. This is the supply where we will give fixed AC supply, and this one is the load, and here we will take only resistive load. So here if you observe this waveform, this is the supply voltage, pure sinusoidal voltage, and here this one is IG signal of thyristor 1, and this one is IG signal of thyristor 2, and here you will get the output voltage. When we apply alpha here, then the T1 starts conducting up to pi. So alpha to pi, T1 is starts conducting. Whereas T2, see here, for T2 we are giving pi plus alpha, triggering at pi plus alpha, then in this duration the supply or output voltage is zero. So negative, see here, the negative supply is controlled by this T2. So T1 conduct for positive half cycle and T2 is conducting for negative half cycle. Finally, if you observe, this is the output voltage, controlled output voltage of regulator with R load. If you want current, so this voltage by resistance you will give this current value, same shape, but it is less than the value of voltage. So once if you observe this voltage across the thyristors, so here when the supply voltage is positive, this acts as a short circuit. So in this duration, the output voltage across the first thyristor is zero. In this negative half cycle, so here the output voltage is zero. So this conduct for positive half cycle and this conduct for this is zero for negative supply voltage. Here we can observe, here this is the triggering signal we are giving. First one is triggering signal, this is the supply voltage, this is the output voltage, green line is the output voltage, and current line, red line, is the output current. So same shape, but its magnitude is less than this one. Why? Because we are dividing voltage by resistance. So when it is conducting, it acts as a short circuit, that's why the supply voltage is zero. When this one is acting, the voltage across the second thyristor is zero. So here we can calculate RMS value. Here average value is zero. Why? Because it is a symmetrical, we will get average value as zero, but we can calculate RMS value. So this is the RMS value of the single phase fully controlled with resistive load. So we can calculate the different out RMS value of current, RMS value of voltage and the current, output power, and also power factor. So this is with the RL load. When L is connected across the load, then we will get some change in the output voltage. So same case, when the alpha triggering signal is given to the alpha, then first thyristor starts conducting, this thyristor is conducting up to alpha to pi plus beta, where beta is called extension angle, alpha is called delay angle, and the gamma is called conduction angle here. So here beta is equal to alpha plus gamma. So where that is a conduction period of T2. So here, because of this inductance value, the voltage is going to negative in direction, but current is in the positive direction. So because of this inductance, we will get continuous current. At the same time, we can generate the regenerative voltage, and we can get smooth continuous current when we increase the inductance value. So this is the shape with the mixed different colors. So we can observe this total waveforms in the single waveform, different waveforms in single waveform. The more advantages of AC voltage controller is high efficiency, compact size, flexibility in control, and fast response.